My grandfather served in World War I. He was actually a lieutenant in World War I. And my dad served in Korea, and he served in Vietnam. And then I joined the military in 1982, in November. And it's a heritage that started with my grandfather, and it continued with my dad. It continued down to me, and I think it'll continue to my kids. And it wasn't that it was expected that you were going to join the service. It was just something I always thought that I would do. For me, if I was going to go, I was going to go all the way.
This is skydiving over Fort Benning, Georgia. Sunset jump.
The job of the Army Rangers is to do the job that nobody else can do. Mission accomplishment, it's a foregone conclusion.
One thing we tell guys when they get here, you know, they're three times volunteers, you know, because they volunteered to come into the Army, they volunteered to go through airborne school, and then they volunteered to come to Ranger Battalion.
They train harder and longer than anybody else.
Then me and Dave, after the 25-mile run, we're just coming in.
They train so that they can do their missions blindfolded with half their brains tied behind their back if necessary, in their sleep, and they do it over and over and over again until they've got it down cold, and then they do it again.
And that's my buddy Max Mullen. That guy was one big, huge muscle. He's huge.
There's no sleep, hardly. There's hardly any food. There's a lot of intense pressure. The last 3 weeks of Ranger School, I lost 55 pounds. There's no way I was quitting. You do all that for 68 days, so you can get a 39-cent piece of black and gold cloth that says Ranger on it. For me, it was worth it.
Second Lieutenant Burnett. Wow.
I wanted to serve my country, and I want to serve it. My country at the best capacity I could.
When I look at, you know, Lynn's generations of guys, that was the first time that the United States military decided to not only activate Ranger Battalion during a time of peace, but to keep it as a regular unit that would always be a part of the Army.
We shot that sign full of holes on the DMZ.
You know, I kind of think of those guys as the pioneers to the modern Rangers.
We're both instructors. This is 10,000 feet over South Korea.
Being a great patriot, it's taking your eyes off yourself and not focusing on what is necessarily the best for you in your situation, but what is best for your country.
I'd done everything I wanted to do in the Army, so I knew at that point it was time for me to move on and do other things. When I got out of the military, I felt an obligation to continue to serve my country in any way I could.
Lynn's been volunteering for the USO here at Joint Base Lewis-McChord for 2 years. He volunteers with his wife, Jo.
Every week we go down and the soldiers will come in prior to leaving on a deployment. We'll usually give them a deployment packet. We make them feel comfortable.
I couldn't be more proud of a guy that goes out of his way to provide the best service for our soldiers and our airmen and their families.
We take our kids out there because I want to teach my kids that freedom isn't free.
Our goal, obviously, is not to get emotional, but is to have a smile on our face and to let them know that we appreciate them, that we respect them.
They're the ones who are getting on a plane and leaving their family to protect our freedoms. The least I can do is to shake their hand and thank them, and that they know that, you know, they have the thanks of a grateful nation. I believe there are servicemen and women who live with a sense of obligation to protect our freedom. And I'm glad to be a part of that group of men and women who've served to protect those freedoms. My father did, my grandfather did, I hope my children do. It's why we have a great nation. It's not because of politicians, it's not because of just business people, it's because of servicemen and women who've worn the uniform. You know, I don't ever consider serving my country something that constitutes hero status. And to me, heroes are people who have given the last full measure of dedication to their country.